Okay, so what we're doing is my sweep single leg. So my takedowns, I break into two sides. So one is if I manage to get the collar grip with my right hand, and one if I try and do this but I'm blocked, so Barry blocks me, yeah, and I make the grip with my left hand. So I've got two different takedowns depending on which grip I can get at the start. So if I get this one, so I'm gonna slap this loose and grab with my right hand. I have a bend in my elbow, and then I'm gonna grab the wrist here. Now I'm just gonna pull, because I want Barry to step, sweep to the outside, and then I wrap. So I've got two hands on the collar. I stand up, and then I can finish the takedown like this. So I'm gonna make the first grip, grab, just intercept Barry's hand, pull to get him to step, go for the collar, step up, keeping his posture broken, and then I can switch to the other side. And now I'm in a good passive position. Do one more from this side. So I make the grip, pull, sweep to the outside, step up, and then go for the pass. So that's a sweep single. Second one then is, if I'm going for this one but Barry just intercepts my hand, he blocks me, so I grab with my other hand. So now what I'm going to do is, I'll do this slow just so we can do a practice. So I'm going to pull to step here, I'm going to drop for this safada takedown. I'm going to try and grip here, doesn't work, I grab here. Trying grip, not working. And take down. And I just need to make sure that I beat this knee. So if Barry manages to get his knee here, well then I have to fight into half guard. So as soon as I land, I need to step over and switch my base. So I'm gonna pull to here, and then I kneel over this knee and drop my face on this side. Nice. Okay. So guard pull, I'm gonna make the same grip and grab the sleeve. I'm gonna pull because I want Barry to step. If he's not gonna step with that rear foot, I can move myself around. Okay, so I want my lead foot, because I have this hand gripped, I want my lead or my right foot going onto that hip. Switch to the ankle, this foot treads in, push, pull, and then come up with passing position. Okay, foot on the hip, grab the ankle, this comes in behind the ankle, push, pull, and then I'm off into a good passing position. Grab the wrists, foot on the hip, and then come up. If I miss this grip, it's same thing. So if I can't make this grip, so Barry blocks my hand and I make the other grip. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch and I pull out to this side. So this time I have the collar and I have the wrist to the outside, and here I can start to look for an omoplata for the sweep. So trying to make the same grip, he blocks, I get my left hand grip. So I'm still gonna sit with my right foot. So this can be tricky because Barry can just batten that leg out of the way. So what I can do is I can sit with this foot here, switch, and then straight into the omoplata to here. And then just a normal finish for the omoplata, or use it to sweep.
Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again.
Cork sleeper.
No, that's not cork sleeper. This is the cork sleeper. Remember this cork sleeper?
No.
It's from Cork.
From Cork?
Anyway, we're not doing the cork sleeper. We're doing a kimura sleeper where we go to the underhook side. So if I let go of this, Foxy can use this hand.
to push my head out. This one, push my head out and get back to the mat. So once I keep this, it's preventing him from putting... One way he's not getting his back on the mat. The second way is I keep my chin on his shoulder. The third way is I tread, keep that leg up, I tread my top foot across. Right, so now my body's... See the way my elbows connect to my knee? It's harder for him to get into that space. So, from here, if Foxy's just like this, I choke him. Right, so he won't be like that. He's going to be protecting his neck. Yeah. So, I'm going to use this foot. No, I'm not. Watch this. Sorry. What's it called? Action! So, watch. This, what I want to do is I want to get to here. But Foxy's protecting his neck, and he's going to be protecting strong here, because if I let go, so most likely I'm going to have to do like an Anderson Silva elbow here. I'm going to have to whip this back home, right? So it's going to have to be one, two, and there's my kimura grip. Because I'm not going to be able to just take it out because his grip is too strong, especially Nogi. So it's going to have to be one, two, right? And then three is here. You see how my heel comes in front of his foot, put that back, in front of his forearm, heel into his chest. And now this foot goes here. And I let him roll here. And so I go square on my hips. Now watch my kimura grip switches to a Dave Camarillo.
Oh, God!
And we get to tap. What does Dave Camarillo call this? Taurus hammer?
SM!
So kimura seatbelt, chin, kimura grip, tread this foot across. Here and here, straight away here, here, roll onto my hips, square on my hips, switch to Dave Camarillo's grip. There's that tap. That's part one.
Oh, that's part one.
There's four parts to this.
Oh, I'm so happy.
I'm going to be four parts of only two arms.
Part two, look. So simple. Straight arm.
That's important to see the whole thing. I think.
I'll go.
Yeah, just need, we need to change the holes. Yeah.
So look, this is what happens a lot of times here. Foxy knows I'm trying to arm lock him. And this grip here is getting weaker. This heel has to be in tight in against his chest, right? This closes his loop. So a lot of times what people are going to do is they let go here. His hand comes around and he grabs his hand again because he knows I'm trying to arm lock him.
And then switch. Reverse
hand.
Exactly. So watch, I keep the kimura grip, same grip. Let's go switch to using my thumb. I'm gonna reach over, grab my shin, switch. And when we go here, I don't attack the triangle, I always attack.
Yeah.
Simple.
Yeah.
That works better than no-gi.
I don't know if I have the question right. So the question was, lads, framing on your face and keeping their weight back. So I presume he means they're sitting upright, but like that they're sitting back, pinching their knees maybe. I don't know. So I'd have to read the question again, but that they're using the forearm or collar grip. I think to try and see here maybe that they're keeping their weight back to that you're getting past. I think the first problem would be that anytime you let anybody touch your head or touch your collar in half guard, it's a bad idea anyway. So you need to be fighting this very hard. So I don't want to let him get near either for like just a simple cross face, like it's a long way back from here, or even if he controls this sleeve, I don't like that either, especially for him. So he does starts to control my arm and try to pass it underneath his arm, or even just to get his thumb inside my collar. And a lot of times, lads will be here, they'll be very comfortable with this. The guy gets his thumb inside your collar, he's like, I still got my frames here. He just opens this elbow now, like this way, and begins to sit back here. You're gonna be in trouble again. So, I know everybody else, underhook, underhook, underhook. Underhook's very important. But I think especially when the guy's sitting back, it's all about protecting this space here and controlling this space here. So when Roger starts to reach for that, I go here, and I actually like this grip here, look. C grip or clamp grip here, but not too tight, just on his elbow. So that whenever he sort of tries to now try and get past my elbow here, even if he grips my sleeve here now, just I can keep this kind of reasonably under control. And I'm gonna take my other hand, and I'm gonna go spider grip on this side, here. Now, either you're nice and flexible, or you need to like make a little bit of space, but one way or the other, this foot's coming over the top here. And I like this very much, because it keeps Roger in a much better, keeps him a little bit away from me, creates this little bit of distance here. Just a little quick note on your lasso here. It doesn't have to be super deep, okay? And you don't have to have his hand look up at your rockster here. You can just clamp as long as you close your wrist here, you're all right, okay? So what you're gonna do now is you're gonna be in this fight here like this, and you're gonna bait him to grab your head, okay? Well, as you do that, once he goes for your head, I'm gonna kick this leg straight, and I'm gonna shoot my hand underneath his, I'm gonna punch him in the face there first. I'm gonna shoot my hand underneath his legs. So as I feel him, he's going from here, I've gone through under, I've baited him to grab my head, and from here now, I'm gonna bring him to this position here. Just as I sweep, just as you feel the sweep come on, this is the next thing you can start to pass from here, of course. Just take a big step with your foot here to go over the top. You can, of course, go just sit into his half guard on the other side as well if you want to. Just look again. So, I've knee shield. I go C grip on his arm here, like this, clamp grip, or good defensive wall here. I'm flexible enough to bring my leg in. If you're not, a little hip escaping, then go back in. Once again, just keep this tight. Here he is, he's looking for your head. He's trying to come in, grab your head. When you feel it goes, this is all about timing. Shoot and shoot. Almost going straight to your back. Moving underneath him here like this. And now my grip is still on his sleeve. But as I just tilt, I'm gonna bring my elbow to the mat here now. High step. Folding lasso. Leg drag, whatever you guys call it at home. One more time. The belt's coming off, that's terrible infection.
Action. What's your first shot?
Right. Where did I get this deal?
Okay. Okay, so I want to armlock this arm. I'm going to bait Barry by pushing down, and most likely when I push down here, he gives me the resistance and there's a bit of a spring. So I push, as he springs, shift my body across. Oh, knees wide, hands wide, and the weight of my hips now is pinning this arm across his body. So the weight of my hips, when my knees go wide, there's no weight on my knees, it goes here. So, here's what I don't want to happen. When I start turning this way, I don't want Barry to go on the side. I want Barry's two shoulder blades on the mats, right? So if I just go from here and start trying to arm lock from here, he starts to go on the side. I might get it, but he's able to move a lot more. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my elbow. One, to make him look up. Two, this arm comes in. So there's two things to stop him from turning. One, two, yeah? Oh, okay. Now, my weight goes here and I bring my left elbow, my left knee to my left elbow. One. Here, my weight is still here, so as soon as I can, I switch to that. I switch to this side. Right, and I haven't even worried about his arms yet.
Oh, great, you're gonna do it again.
Up. Right, so Barry now is concerned about this arm. He knows this is the arm I'm gonna armlock. So I'm gonna trick him a little bit. I'm gonna go here. I go up, arm across, a pinch. And now all he has left is this. So even if he's grabbing his gi here, I'm gonna come inside. I'm gonna grab the pad of his thumb. And I'm gonna use my hip behind his elbow, foot on the mat. And I'm gonna go tap long. I'm just gonna do one more.
Oh yeah.
And switch it. Come back. I'm trying to break this grip. I can't break it for whatever reason. I'm gonna grab his elbow here, pinch my knees. And I'm gonna shift up this way, attack his shoulder. Yeah. There you go. Basic arm lock with a bit of fanciness thrown in at the end.
Doing a bow and arrow choke. Do it from a pass. So here, what I'm trying to do is Roger is playing De La Hiva because he loves De La Hiva guard. So I'm gonna use this collar grip. I use my forearm just to get rid of that. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna do a leg drag. So just transfer this, pull it past, keep this arm straight. And now as Roger, if he pushes with this hand, he's trying to deflect. I'm gonna just do a two on one, almost like an arm drag again, or a leg drag. So like I've just gone here, I'd leg drag this, I do the same with that arm. From here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch to the top collar. So I'm gonna punch this to the floor. We can do the other angle now in a sec. And I'm gonna dive in, already looking for this grip on the collar. And then I've got transition back up. I go here, I'm using my chest to push away. And now I'm gonna just chest this, pull through to the other side. Once I go to here, I come up on my elbow, grab the leg, go under or go over the shoulder with my other leg, and just finish. From this angle, I step in, go two and one here. At this stage, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab this collar and I punch it straight, and I'm gonna dive in and make my grip. Transition back up using my chest. Chair sit and go to the side. So go to this side, I come up onto my elbow, I'm looking for the leg, bring my other leg over the shoulder, cross my feet if I can, and just finish here.